You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about what's new with Translator, not just text in a box, but much more. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we've got a special guest with us, Krishna, to talk about what's new with Translator. Krishna, tell us who you are and what you do, my friend.
Hi, I work as a principal program manager at Microsoft. I've been with Microsoft for 15 plus years, and I'm responsible for Translator Service and Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services.
Fantastic. So here's a question. When we talk about translation of text, I'm used to like going to a website and typing in some text, and then out comes the text in a different language. Is this what we're talking about, like an API? How long have we been doing it? How many languages do we support?
We have been doing this for more than 10 years in Microsoft Translator Service. And currently we support more than 70 plus languages in our service.
That's amazing. Like, is it? And we have APIs that you can just call and give text to, and then languages come back. Is that right?
Yep. It's a very simple API, and you make a post request and give a body, and in your request body you give your text and specify what's your from language and to language, and we get the translated text back in Civi, and it's a real-time translation.
So this is really cool. So how are customers receiving this? How are they using it? How can we inspire other people to use it as well? Any challenges that they've had?
Yes. So Microsoft Translator is one of the highly consumed cognitive services. In spite of that, we keep getting feedback from customers to increase the character limits in our real-time translation API request. And then we said, okay, let's speak to these customers, and spoke to those customers and understood what customers are actually doing about with translating large content of text. And then we found that customers are really actually dealing with documents. It means customer extract textual content from the document, splits them into smaller chunks, translate them using our service, and merge all those translated chunks back to reconstruct a translated document. It's really pain when they translate huge volume of documents.
So really what customers were doing, they were like, text in a text box is great, or an API, let's just say. But what they were doing is they were taking documents, let's just say, I'm assuming like a Word document, and they were taking out the text, translating it, and then putting it back in. Is that right?
Yes. It's not just the Word document. They translate Word, Excel, PowerPoint, PDF, any kind of document. So you make a presentation for your company, and it's an MNC company. You want to transfer this document, PowerPoint presentation in one language into Yen languages, then that's what they're doing it.
So did we want them to keep doing it this way? Did we introduce anything to make it a little bit better for them?
Absolutely not. So we don't want them to spend a whole lot of time in passing the document. It's a technology in there, and what we are going to do is soon we are introducing an asynchronous document translation feature as part of Microsoft Translator Service, which enables user to translate large volume of documents in variety of file formats, including text, HTML, Word, PowerPoint, Excel, Outlook messages, or even Adobe PDF, easily into a single or multiple target languages. Same time, we are going to preserve the layout and structure as in the original file format.
So this is actually really cool, because basically customers were showing you what it is that they were doing, and then you said, why not make a service out of it? I'm still a little confused about how it might work. Is there a way that you can show us?
Sure. So here you could see two files in English document stored under source EN container under a subfolder demo one. And we are going to translate these two files into Spanish language and store them into a container's target ES. Okay. And I have generated SAS token with time limits for the source and target containers with necessary read and write permission.
Okay. So let's pause right here. If I can ask a couple of questions. So basically what customers need to do is put their documents into some kind of blob storage and just put them there. Is that right? And then the service will Absolutely. Take those things out of there. Okay. Okay, cool, cool.
Absolutely. They just put the documents over the source container in a blob storage and provide read permission to us and create a target container and provide write permission to us and make a service request, and I would show about it, and then boom, the translation happens and the translator files goes back to the target container.
So let's pause right here if that's okay. So basically what you're doing is it looks like you're making a post to an endpoint, but instead of just sending text, you're sending a location where there might be a lot of documents and then a target location to push the translation of those documents out. Is that right?
Absolutely right. Okay. And we have some more additional nuances to it. And user can provide various filters to translate files in a specific folders, or they can specify filters like, hey, file starting with something and files ending with blah. Those kind of filters we provide. And the good part is we also enable custom translation. The customer can specify, hey, use the default translation models, or they've spent a good amount of time in building a custom translation model using our custom translator service, and they can reuse that here and translate the documents using their own custom models.
I see. And this is really cool, because basically what you're doing is you're submitting a batch job of a set of documents, and you're basically sending the API a bunch of instructions on here's what you need to do with all these documents. Am I getting this right?
Absolutely. So you specify in the source URL, the source URL where you have the container, and you specify the SAS key, and you specify what's the source language. And similarly, you specify the target container URL and model and the target language. And good thing is you can specify n number of targets and we translate into multiple languages.
Oh, so and you can do multiple languages at the same time too?
Yes, cool. In a single request.
That's cool. How long does the process usually take?
This process, the power of this service relies on when you translate large number of documents in a single request, we could get, say something like, if you send 10 plus documents, we could send in, complete in 20 minutes. It means on an average, we could get documents translated in less than 2 minutes.
That's cool. So basically this batch job is something you send, and it's something maybe you do at night and then come back to work. Well, we're all working from home a little bit too, but you come back to work and everything is basically done for you. Yep. Do you have examples of what this process looks like at the end? I'm sure we probably don't want to just look at it.
Yep. Let me show you the document. So here's the sample document in English. And here is the translated document. I'm showing it side by side so that you can get a feel of it. And this Word document gets translated using the service, which preserves the layout and structure as it's in the original document. And here you can see the headings, bold are preserved, and the table layouts are preserved, and the highlights are preserved. And not just the Word file, you can also see the same document. We had English file in PDF, and we have the same thing got translated using the service into Spanish. And you could see how good it preserved the layout and structure of the document. This is unique to our service.
This is my surprised face. I didn't realize that we were also preserving document structure. This is amazing. So let's just say you have some training documents, mm-hmm. and you read them all in Word, because that's, I don't know, people do that. You can literally have all of those translated, send one call at the end of your workday when you finish all the docs, and the next day you can have them all translated in whatever languages you want. Is that correct?
Exactly. Absolutely.
This is impressive. Where can people go to find out more about this?
So the service is going to be public preview soon. Currently, it's in private preview with select set of customers. Soon it will be open to public preview. That's where we'll provide a link down this as part of this video session. You can go there and learn more about when it is coming and how to use the service.
Well, this has been fantastic. Thank you so much for spending some time with us, Krishna. And again, thank you so much for watching. We've been learning about some of the cool new features in Translator here on the AI Show. Hopefully, we'll see you next time. Take care.